The Antifa are the real fascist meme needs to die. That's if it is not already dead. Antifa are not fascist. They are communist at least and anarchist at most. Aside from perhaps a similar temperament in that they are fascistic, as in to say, have similar authoritarian or totalitarian tendencies which lead to similar outcomes. But strictly speaking, they are otherwise polar opposites in ideals. They are anti-far right because they are pro-far left. They take on the name Antifa, anti-fascist, as a mere public relations ploy to convince gullible people into joining their ranks and make them feel like they're fighting a good fight. If their name was something like pro-com for pro-communist or pro-anna for pro-anarchist, they wouldn't be nearly as popular, but they would at least be honest about who they are. Otherwise, it's just disingenuous and a blatant case of deception. However, philosophically, it is essentially impossible for the far left to be pro-anything because, inherently, they are not focused on construction of the current order, only deconstruction. Strictly characterized by an insatiable need to be in a mindset of constant revolution and chaos, until they have all but leveled out society and flattened civilization to the point of complete nothingness, or stateless society, in the utopian hope that man is naturally good, peaceful, and only corrupted by civilization, in a perfect state of nature. This is the Rousseauian noble savage. A fascist is the philosophical opposite, as basically, fascism is a radical interpretation of the worldview of Thomas Hobbes, or Hobbesian philosophy. They are different in that a fascist sees man as naturally bad, violent, and corrupt in a state of nature, or his natural state, and therefore believes that a strong and big government, also known as Hobbes' Leviathan, is necessary to maintain order and protect the individual from themselves, thereby preventing a return to a brutal, short, and hellish survival of the fittest nightmare scenario. In simple terms, much of the debate over human history and the inherent nature of man stems primarily from the argument between French philosopher Jean-Jacques Rousseau and English philosopher Thomas Hobbes, and it has been that way for centuries. The arguments may be structured or worded differently today, but when you cut away all the excesses of politics or issue-based debate, the big arguments or personal ideological decisions are inherently the same and have the same logical conclusions they have always had. So the most basic way to find out whether someone is prone to liberal, as in left-leaning, or illiberal, as in right-leaning views, is to ask them whether they honestly believe humans are inherently good or inherently corrupt. If they answer good, they are Rousseauian or left-wing. And if they answer corrupt, they are Hobbesian or right-wing. If they answer both, that is a moderate position akin to the golden mean or Aristotelian virtue. That position is legitimate, but it is also safe, as it attempts to diffuse the idea of a left-right paradigm or the danger of a friend-enemy dialectic. If one is a genuine moderate or apolitical type, one will still have to stand their ground or fight for their ideological position. Remaining strictly rational or neutral and objecting to conflict in a pacifistic way does not and will not leave you immune to its consequences.